When using Earthwork Pro, there are two primary ways you'll take off your existing and proposed elevations: using spot elevations or drawing contours. In this video, we'll cover drawing contours. When drawing elevations, you outline the topographical areas corresponding to the existing and proposed grades. Once complete, Earthwork Pro compares the existing and proposed grades and calculates the cut and fill values required for the proposed elevations. After loading your job and scaling your page, you can draw the contours using the tools found in the Earthwork Pro templates in the Templates panel. There are templates for existing and proposed pre-shaded areas. There are 6 of each set up with different colors, but you can use the tools as many times as necessary. There are also existing and proposed random color tools that work the same way. It's crucial to remember that whether you are doing spots, contours, or a combination of the two, the existing and proposed takeoff must be on the same page. Launch any takeoff tool by hovering over it and selecting the green button. The properties window for the pre-shaded area displays. You can also click the pre-shaded icon in the Earthwork Pro section on the Home tab ribbon bar to add contours. If you choose this method, you must select existing or proposed from the tool type field. You can adjust the name, elevation, description, and color in the properties window. It's essential to enter the elevation carefully, as a mistake here can throw off your cut and fill numbers significantly. Enter the elevation listed on the plan, an average elevation, or an approximate value if nothing is listed, whichever makes the most sense in your situation. You can also check the Show Elevation Adjustment Options checkbox. This checkbox adds additional elevation fields, which allow you to increase or decrease the base elevation. We'll come back to this a bit later in the video. For now, let's click OK to save and close the Preferences window. Before you start drawing your contours, it's a good idea to change your drawing mode. Ortho mode is on by default, which keeps your lines perfectly straight or at 45 or 90 degree angles. This mode is excellent for drawing square buildings, but for topographic lines, this mode can get in the way. Left-click Ortho at the bottom of the screen to turn it off. While you're down there, it's a good idea to turn Snap mode on. Snap mode allows you to perfectly match up or snap new lines against existing ones, so there are no gaps or overlaps between elevation areas. Now, let's start drawing. Locate one of the contours on your plan and left-click to begin. Move around the contour, clicking each point where you need to change directions. It doesn't matter if you move clockwise or counterclockwise, just so long as you move in the same direction once you start. Drawing contours is the same process as performing area takeoff. For more information, see the training videos Creating a New Area Takeoff and How to Draw a Radius or Arc. Once you've gotten one contour drawn, use the Earthwork Pro templates to create another contour for your next elevation. Let's do the contour right next to the one we just drew. Just like before, left-click to start drawing. Since we turned on Snap mode, you can easily trace along one of the lines of your previous takeoff to ensure your new contour follows it precisely. Okay, with the existing contours finished, it's time to draw our proposed contours. Like I said earlier, for Earthwork Pro to correctly calculate the cut and fill, you must ensure you draw the existing and proposed contours on the same page. It's important to see the contour lines on the page as clearly as possible so you can draw them accurately. You can hide the takeoff you just drew so that you can draw your proposed takeoff with nothing in your way. Select the View tab at the top of the screen and click the Hide Digitizer Items button on the ribbon bar. This option hides all of your existing takeoff but won't hide anything new. Once you've drawn everything, you can go back and click Show Digitizer Items to bring everything back. Speaking of proposed takeoff, you may need to include working space around it when taking off an area. For example, if you're excavating a building, you'll take off the building shape. However, you also need space for your crew and equipment to get where they need to place things like footings or slabs. There's a tool called Working Space in the Earthwork Pro Tools section to account for this extra space. To add working space, select the proposed area and click the Working Space button. The Add Workspace window appears, where you can add how much space you need to add around your workspace. Depending on how you set up your job, you can enter this space in feet or meters. Once entered, click OK and the area automatically expands to account for the extra space. Now, let's go back and discuss the Elevation Adjustment Options checkbox. In this example, we have a proposed contour spanning a trail. The plan shows a finished elevation of 790 feet across this area, which includes the top of the finished pavement. As an earthwork contractor, you may not be concerned with the 8 or so inches that make up the paving and only want to account for the dirt. So you can take off the paved area using a different pre-shaded takeoff and use the elevation adjustment options to decrease the elevation by 8 inches. Alternatively, you may know that the compaction rate for a given material is about 10%. So you could increase the elevation by a certain amount to account for that because you know the finished elevation would end up too low otherwise. In either example, you can be sure your grading calculations are correct. With your existing and proposed contours complete on the same page, you're ready to send this data to Earthwork Pro for calculating the cut and fill.
Before you build, construct Connect.